So a few days ago, the creators of Ark released their new game into early access on Steam, Atlas, and some players are not happy. Let's talk about this. Hey everybody, what is going on? Brandon here. I hope you guys had an awesome holiday. We got New Year's just a few more days out, and a few days ago we had Atlas drop on the Steam Marketplace. Now this was a game that had a lot of hype behind it, so when it dropped, it prompted me to get my hands on it and to get a video out for it ASAP before the new year rolls around. And lo and behold, this game has a lot that I can make content on, so I decided to bring up the biggest thing that's going on right now, and that is all the negativity surrounding this game, some of the backlash from launch, and just kind of discuss this a little bit with you guys. Now, this is not going to be my early impressions review video. I am doing that. I plan on hopefully having that up in about a week or so. I want to try to get as much done on this game and really grind out as much as I can, because this is a survival game. There's a lot of grinding. I want to get a lot more done into the game so I can show you guys a little bit of later progress stuff, not just some of the stuff you can get in the first couple days. So this isn't my early impressions video. That video will be coming. But this is to discuss some of the backlash and some of the negativity going on with the game. Now, this game released a few days ago, and the day one launch was pretty much a ball drop. It was a pretty bad launch, but for a lot of us, it was to be expected. Now, this game is an alpha. It's, you know, you are paying to test the game. You're getting it for a lot cheaper than what it's going to be when it comes out, as we've seen with other early access games that go from 20 to 30 to 60 when they're released. So you're getting it at a good price, but it is an alpha. There's a lot of bugs. There's a lot of things that need worked out in it. So I expected the day one launch issues. I, you know, did not expect anything less. Now, the reason I expected this game to have a terrible day one launch is because it was a giant MMO. It's a massive MMO, and almost any big, massive online game like this has issues day one. It's pretty much a guaranteed. Even AAA titles usually do it. Sea of Thieves had issues. Fallout 76 had issues. And those games aren't nearly the scale or scope as this game is, so I definitely expected the day one issues, and a lot of us did. A lot of us anticipated that it would, because you need to stress test servers, and you can't stress test a server made to hold 20,000 people without having 20,000 people on there. Not only that, but the magnitude of the game, the scale, each one of these grids is an individual server in this cluster, in this world, and they all hold 200 people, and once you cross a certain line, you're migrated to another server. And it's the way they've got it all meshed together is to make the world humongous and massive. And so for that reason, I expected, with all the different server migration from people traveling and all the different people jumping into this game at once, I knew there was going to be day one issues. But some people were not happy with these day one issues at all. I mean, there's a lot of people left negative reviews. Right now, it's still sitting on mostly negative on Steam. And to me, that's not really very fair. Because especially when you go through and you read a lot of the reviews, most of these people tried to play the game for about a half hour, couldn't get into the servers on day one, left a nasty review and refunded it. And that's kind of abusing the refund system and abusing the review system in my eyes, because this game is in early access. There is a huge warning label on the front page of the store before you spend $20 on it that it's in early access. It may not work at all. There might be parts of the games that don't work at all. It might not ever get fixed. It might not ever get finished. It's a big warning label that Steam puts on the front of all their early access games, pretty much warning you before you buy the game. Look, this is an alpha. You are testing this game. It might not ever be finished. You might be wasting your money. And, you know, this game may never work. And to me, I like the fact that that early access clause is there on the front, because in a way, it helps with a lot of people like myself who are going to be testing the game to not really pay attention to a lot of the negative reviews. But it does affect the game to the general consumer, and that's kind of the issue that I have with all of this negative backlash. And like I said, this isn't my early impressions video for Atlas. I will be doing that later to discuss how I feel about some of the things in there and some of the bugs that I've experienced, my thoughts on some of it. I'm just wanting to give it a little bit more time into the game before I do that video. But when it comes to the negative backlash, it's getting a little bit ridiculous. You've got people posting on Steam forums that they want to sue because this is blatant fraud, because after 3 hours into the game, they haven't seen any of the stuff that was in the trailer, and it's like, that's in-game stuff. That's stuff that's going to be in the end of the game, or it might not even be in there now, but it will probably be in there by the time it's released. But the game's only been out, I think, 4 days now, and for people to be complaining this bad over things that aren't even really bug-related, it's mostly server-related, which anybody should be able to expect these kind of server issues with a game like this of this magnitude this early on. One thing that I've seen thrown around a lot and is actually, you know, in my eyes, it's kind of silly. I can see where they're coming from to an extent, but also you need to think about it from a business standpoint, is people screaming, well, this is just a mod for Arc. They're just trying to make a cash grab. If you do this with a controller, you can get to this menu and you can see that it's the Arc menu with the map ocean. Oh, it's just a mod. Okay, it's not a mod. It would be a pretty extensive mod if it was, especially for the scale of the map and the servers. Yes, they are building off the Arc structure. That's a given. That's smart, though. I would rather them be building off something that was already working and then expand on that and make it their own and make a whole new project out of that, then start from scratch. Because if they were starting from scratch, we would probably not have this game for about another 2 years, and then it would be entering early access. So in my eyes, thank God they are using the same structure from Arc and building off of that rather than making a whole new game, which would be in a lot worse shape than this one is now. All in all, some of the negativity I can understand to an extent. I can understand being upset that you couldn't get into the servers on day one, or understand that occasionally there are server issues when you can't connect, and there's been quite a few patches. That's another thing that people are using as a negative when it should be taken as a positive, is how many patches this game has had since it launched, them trying to fix issues. People are using that as a negative to throw at the developers that, oh God, this game is so awful, they've already had to do this many patches. In my eyes, you know, that's good. If a game company is willing to work basically right up to Christmas Day, then back again on Christmas night, and be putting out patches for these games, that to me shows a dedicated developer and community feedback. If they're listening to the community and getting patches out that quickly, and yeah, sure, sometimes the patches might not fix what they're intending them to, but they're at least trying. That's showing me that they're at least attempting to make the game good and make it fun. And this game does have issues. I'm not going to lie about it and say this game doesn't have issues. I mean, it's an alpha. There's been several issues that I've had with it, and some of which are laughable, like a horse swimming underwater, like walking around like it's supposed to be there and it's not even in the right biome. Stuff like that is laughable. I've had characters wiped 3 times, which sucked. I've had issues with this game, but not for the reasons that everybody else is complaining. I mean, for the most part, all these negative reviews from people that have like 15 minutes in and couldn't play because of the server issues, and then they refunded and left a nasty review, that just, to me, sucks, because it is going to tarnish the reputation of the game in the long run. And Arc was a pretty big disaster when it launched initially. I had Arc, wasn't day one, I think it was like day 5 that Arc was out in early access. I got it, and it was a pretty, you know, it was a pretty big wreck back then. And, you know, now it's probably one of my top 10 most underrated games that I love because of how much you can do. Now, this game is a sandbox game. Atlas is a lot like Arc in that aspect. You need to survive. It's got, you know, some things that are different than the Arc, though. I mean, you have vitamins you need to make sure you keep track of, because if you don't have enough, you will get sick and die. That's something I really like, even though I do wish they would tweak it some. But there are things that set this game apart from Arc, not just giant pirate ships, which are pretty cool, though. All in all, though, I'm having a good time with Atlas. I'm having fun. Yes, there's some issues. Yes, I've had to reset my character multiple times because of bugs. Yes, I've had server issues where I couldn't connect. But all in all, I expected all of this early in the stage. It doesn't really shock me at all. I've played a lot of early access games, so at this point, I am not shocked. And I really like the scope of this game and what it could possibly become. And I'm looking forward to that. For a lot of these YouTubers and people leaving reviews and journalists bashing the game because of the server issues on day one so they could get views, to me, that's kind of ridiculous. You shouldn't really do that on day one of an early access title. It is kind of a crappy thing to do. Now, I know a lot of you are probably saying, well, Brandon, you ripped into DayZ and it was in early access. But let's face facts here. DayZ was in early access for 5 years. So that's why I ripped it a new one. If it had just came out and had been like a week old, I wouldn't have done a review on it and ripped it a new one. But when a game's been out for 5 years, it's still pretty much the price of a full price game, and still doesn't have anything that they promised in any of their recent updates that they've been promising for 5 years, then I'll rip it a new one. Like, if this game in 2 years from now is still in the same shape that it's in now, yeah, I will definitely tear into it with another review. But as of right now, it's only been out for a few days. I'm giving it a shot. I'm having a lot of fun doing it. I'm loving this game so far. I've been sinking a lot of time into it. I'm ready to do an early impressions video where I actually give you guys my thoughts on it. Hopefully that'll be out next week. But yeah, so that's my thoughts on this game. If you guys want to check out Atlas, I'll leave a link in the description so you can go to the store page and check it out. If you want to check it out and you know you understand the risks of buying into an early access, but you're still excited and you want to check it out, check it out. If you are not the type of person to buy into early access, you don't want to test the game, you don't want to experience a lot of bugs or server issues, don't buy the game, because that's just going to make the game look bad when you get mad because you can't connect and you go leave a negative review on a game that warned you the problems were going to be there. So if you don't want to deal with any issues and you don't want to help test the game and grow it, don't bother buying it, because if you buy it and leave a crappy review because you don't like the bugs, you're just making the game look bad when really you just didn't take any heed to any warnings anybody gave you. So, but that's all the time I got for this one, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like this video and you want to see more, please do me a favor and mash that red subscribe button. If you want to know anytime Nathan or I upload videos, please click that bell icon so you'll be sure notifications get sent to you by YouTube. Otherwise, you probably won't get them. But that's all the time I got for this one, guys, and I will see you all next time.